I'd like to jump a little bit to the section neck, top line, and body. Yeah. Can we stand the dog and take
very
a look at the top line?
Very important. Look, in such dogs, Molossian dogs. Molossian top. You can't have, you can never have a back top line. As in a setter, for example, in a Belgian Shepherd, you see, because the dog is generally concave. This concavity you can see in the nose and a little bit in the top line. You see here a little bit coming down here, but it should never be saddled. Well, some pictures are, of course, saddled, but should not be. And I saw today some very bad backs sinking here, which is very, very bad, sagging top line.
In the rear, they
this
should
is
be...
What, this is very, this is what you can obtain. Again, you can never have and it's impossible to have a perfectly straight line as in
In the rear of the body, the it should be a little bit higher in the back, or how is the...
No, when it is higher in the back, it's because the rear angulation is too straight. If the rear angulation is too straight, you have the croup is higher than normal, and then you have a sinking top line. Should not sink here. A little bit lower, it's normal.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Can we see the angulation on this dog?
Yes, angulation.
Can you see it on the camera?
Very important, I must say. Important difference with the Bull Mastiff. The Bull Mastiff's angulations are a bit straighter. It means that the angles are more obtuse, are more open than in the dog body, normally. See? Yeah, it's normal. It's a normal angulation. This angle here is well marked, as you can see. Unhappily, many dog de Bordeaux, not many, but a good number of dog de Bordeaux have bad hind quarters. You should be very strict with cow hocks and all that sort of thing. And also straight angulation. You see on one side straight angulation, the other side is cow hock, the way when you see from behind. So the cow hock is very bad. Yes, look at the back. See this back? This is very, very good, you know? With a good angulation here, you can see the hocks and the typical tail, very, very broad here, not kinked, never kinked. Yeah? It's very good, typical. Also the color is typical, you see, because you see, it's what we call mahogany, but it's only a way of speaking, because scientifically it's formed with, overlaid with brown, you see, or the tips. Only the tips should be. And here you see it becomes paler here, lighter here. It's quite normal. On the shoulders too, the hair is lighter, yellower. This is typically what we call mahogany. That's a very good one.
Can you also point out the angle of the shoulders?
Yes. Well, you know, 90 degrees is probably false. It's simply, I called it propaganda. The problem is, you know, that the angle between the scapula, that is the shoulder blade, and the humerus, that is the arm, is normally in dogs 110, 120 degrees. But in dog de Bordeaux, it's a bit more acute because the legs, as you can see, when you see from the side, the front legs are a little bit backwards. You see, a bit under the body, in front.
Okay.
That's why we say 90. Maybe it's 100. 100.
Okay, and would you make any comparisons in the gait of the Dog de Bordeaux compared to a Bull Mastiff?
Yes, a Bull Mastiff. When you say a Bull Mastiff in static, the forequarters are much straight. You see, for people who don't know the dog, they think they are better because they are upright. A Dog de Bordeaux is never upright because the chest is so broad that the dog has to compensate. And so the forearms here are a little bit convergent, a little bit. And then you have a compensation here. A Dog de Bordeaux, most Dog de Bordeaux, and it is quite normal, have the forefeet a little bit out. Not east and west, of course, but a little bit out is absolutely normal. It is in their nature. That is one great difference. Second great difference, this allows the Dog de Bordeaux to have a very long reach in front. You see, when they walk, they are like a swimmer, crawling swimmer. See, he reaches, we say long reach because he I don't know what you can say, it's a sort of a pendulum, you know, it goes very far ahead. We say that he takes as much ground as he can. And this is why the head goes lower. He lowers his head to enable him to cast his forearm far in front. Typical of the Dog de Bordeaux. And then you have the head is lowered and this part of the back too. In order to walk like this, it's a beautiful gait, long reaching gait. No, long reaching stride. That's the proper term. Long reaching stride in front. Normally, of course, you cannot do that without a thrust, good thrust from behind. See? But the Bullmaster can't do that because he is too perfectly upright in static. This is my opinion. Maybe I'm wrong.
One final question, what would you say in making a judgment when you're judging the Bordeaux, what do you penalize most greatly for if you are selecting between a dog that can move well?
The Dog de Bordeaux, as any dog, should be typical, so type in head. The type in head is not all. A dog should be able to work. It should be sound. So we avoid, formerly we had dogs without enough, insufficient time, no wrinkles, no deep stop, etc. Now we have the proper hands, but sometimes too much. We call it hypertype. That is too much, it means noses that are too short, folds, ugly rolls, eyelids coming down, so you can see the third eyelid. The third eyelid is what you call, the English call haw. Haw should not be visible. It means the third eyelid should not be visible, and also the inside of the eye of the normal eyelid should not be visible either. But so type and soundness. It is good gait, and you just read the standard and you try to apply it. I remind you of one truth, that is the standard is the description of the ideal dog. You try to go as near as possible the ideal dog.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and I believe that we are at the in France today in 2006 at the SABB, the French Club's National Specialty Show, and the dog that we're using as an example was the placed highly in this show. I believe he was reserved male. very good specimen of the breed.
Well, generally in France, the Americans are doing very well because they bring us good good dogs, no doubt about that. Now, when you can see in the show, show we had today, 236, I think, dogs of Bordeaux, which is, I think, the best lesson we can have. Because you see, today we saw, of course, not all of good or very good, but I mean, we saw many, many very, very good specimens. So this should be an example.
Well, once again, thank you, Professor, and thank you for the use of your dog.
Yeah, but I know that it will be the word of the end. You know, I know that the Americans like to be first in everything. I don't doubt you'll become first in the dog de Bordeaux, but in dog de Bordeaux, not an American dog de Bordeaux. A dog de Bordeaux that everybody admires everywhere. I don't doubt you can do that.